Walks right ahead, the phantoms as they approach in an arrowhead formation for a bomb burst maneuver.
Devyo sajo dil tham kar baithe dhamakedar shuruaat ho chuki hai.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Navy Day of Demo.
Ladies and gentlemen, right ahead of you, lurking silently to deliver a decisive punch, is the submarine INS Sindhukirti. To the left and to the right is the Indian Naval sail towing ship INS Tarangini.
देवियों और सज्जनों, अब हमारे ठीक सामने बाईं ओर भारतीय नौसेना की पनडुब्बी सिंधुकीर्ति निर्वरता पूर्वक संचालन कर रही
है। Firing the flares, the submarine Sindhukirti, commanded by Commander Ranjiv Ranjan, and the Indian Naval Sail Training Ship, commanded by Commander Praveen Kumar.
The denizens of the deep, the submarine symbolizes the pinnacle of destructive potential.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a big round of applause for INS Sindhukirti and INS Tarangini.
Tarangini is the first ship of the Indian Navy to have circumnavigated the globe from January 2003 to April 2004. The days of the sail may be old, but never out of style.
देवियों और सज्जनों, आपके समक्ष भारतीय नौसेना के मरीन कमांडो ऑयल रिग डेमोलिशन के लिए सीकिंग चार्ली हेलीकॉप्टर द्वारा स्लिदरिंग ऑपरेशन करने जा रहे हैं। दल का नेतृत्व सब लेफ्टिनेंट अभिषेक मुद्गल और जॉनी चीफ पेटी ऑफिसर क्लियरेंस डाइवर कर रहे हैं।
लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, एज यू कैन सी द सीकिंग चार्ली हेलीकॉप्टर अप्रोचिंग द व्यूइंग गैलरी, द टीम इज लेड बाय सब लेफ्टिनेंट अभिषेक मुद्गल एंड जॉनी Chief Petty Officer Clearance Diver, who will be demonstrating slithering operations and styrops eventually.
अब कमांडर उत्सव मलिक द्वारा संचालित सीकिंग चाली हेलीकॉप्टर से बहादुर मरीन कमांडो जमीनी पर उतर रहे हैं। स्लिदरिंग ऑपरेशन कमांडोज को दुर्गम इलाकों में तेजी से तैनात करने के कई तरीकों में से एक है।
You can now see the commandos slither down onto the Germany from the Seeking Charlie helicopter piloted by Commander Utsav Malik. The helicopter will demonstrate one of the fastest means to deploy marine commandos in an area where helicopters cannot land.
अब आप अपना ध्यान तट की ओर केंद्रित करें। जम्मी में निडर और बहादुर मरीन कमांडो फुर्ती से तट की ओर हमला करने आ रहे हैं। इनका नेतृत्व चीफ पेटी ऑफिसर भरत मिश्रा और पी के गुप्ता कर रहे हैं।
Speeding through the crashing waves using orange smoke to indicate the depth of attack, these Germanis carry the brave and intrepid commandos of the Indian Navy, the Prahars, who belong to the Special Forces Unit INS Karn. Their motto, the few, the fearless.
लहरों पर सवार मार्कोज नारंगी धुएं का उपयोग हमले की स्थिति को इंगित करने और असामाजिक तत्वों को चेतावनी देने के लिए कर रहे हैं। यह भारतीय नौसेना के विशेष बल इकाई आईएनएस कर्ण के मार्कोस का दल है, जो प्रहार के नाम से जाना जाता है। मरीन कमांडोस का आदर्श वाक्य है, द फ्यू द फेयरलेस।
Towards the rear, one of the Germanis swiftly proceeded with a team of clearance divers to place a charge on the mock enemy oil rig to demonstrate demolition of the same. These Marcos are landing on the beach subsequently to demonstrate beach assault of lightly defended enemy location. Look to the right towards the oil rig. Using orange smoke, the diver indicates to the helicopter and his team upon successful placing of charge. You will now witness a small team extraction operation. The Seeking Charlie helicopter will return to recover the diver from the Germany.
अब आपकी दाहिनी ओर नौसेना की क्लियरेंस डाइविंग टीम के गोताखोरों ने ऑयल रिग पर विस्फोटक पदार्थ लगा चुके हैं। डाइवर्स विस्फोटक पदार्थ लगाने के बाद सीकिंग चार्ली हेलीकॉप्टर को नारंगी धुएं के जरिए इशारा कर रहे हैं। हेलीकॉप्टर द्वारा कमांडो को सुरक्षित और तेजी से निकाला जाएगा। इसे स्टाई या स्मॉल टीम इंसर्शन और एक्सट्रैक्शन कहा जाता है।
इन द मीनवाइल मार्कोस आर कैरिंग A beach assault on lightly defended enemy locations. Small, agile, and undefected, these Prahars move towards the beach and skilled in combat to neutralize any apparent threat.
ये वो बहादुर लोग हैं जो amphibious operation के दौरान हमेशा सबसे आगे रहते हैं और तट को advance party द्वारा हमले के लिए तैयार करते हैं।
You can now see the commandos rapidly attaching themselves to the line from the helicopter with a hook.
Marcos khud ko hook ke madhyam se helicopter se feki gayi rassi ko jod rahe hain. Rassi ke judne ke baad ve helicopter ke sang ud jayenge.
All the action takes place with the helo precisely hovering over the position of interest.
स्मॉल टीम इंसर्शन और एक्सट्रैक्शन या स्टाई वह साधन है जिसके द्वारा संचालन पूरा होने पर मार्कोस को तेजी से और सुरक्षित रूप से लड़ाई के क्षेत्र से निकाला जाता है.
Once hooked to the line, the Marcos will fly away, literally hanging down from the helicopter. Obviously, one of the fastest means to recover the commandos from the line of attack. As you can now see, the Marine commandos have been successfully extracted from the line of attack. Ladies and gentlemen, look to your right. The divers have placed the charge and are waiting to demolish the mock oil rig remotely. Ladies and gentlemen, to your right, the explosive has been remotely detonated by the frogmen using Star-Ops. A big round of applause for the daring Marine commandos of the Indian Navy. Ladies and gentlemen, look up and wave as the Marine commandos fly away with the Seek and Charlie helicopters towards your right.
दिव्य सज्जनों, आपको देखने में एक विहंगम दृश्य मिल रहा होगा, परंतु तेज हवा, पानी की बौछार और विमान की उच्च गति के कारण हेलीकॉप्टर से लटकना काफी मुश्किल और जोखिम भरा होता है. दिव्य सज्जनों, सामने से भारतीय नौसेना के छोटे एवं तेज जहाज आ रहे हैं जो शक्ति से भरपूर इमीडिएट सपोर्ट वेसल ISV और फास्ट इंटरसेप्टर क्राफ्ट FIC हैं. इन छोटे जहाजों की उच्च गति और हथियार वितरण का संयोजन इन्हें हमारे अपतटीय प्रतिष्ठानों की सुरक्षा के लिए आदर्श बनाते हैं. आज हम ISV और FIC द्वारा उच्च गति युद्ध अभ्यास को एक आदर्श रूप में देख सकते हैं.
Ladies and gentlemen, sight right ahead the two columns of the smaller but faster ships of the Indian Navy. The power-packed and the ferocious immediate support vessels, ISVs, and the fast interceptor crafts, FICs. These ships may appear small, but the combination of high speed and weapon package makes them the ideal platform to safeguard our offshore installations.
ముందు ఉన్న రెండు ISVలచే FICలు లీడ్ చేయబడతాయి. వెనుక నుండి దూసుకువస్తున్న FICల కోసం నిశ్చితంగా గమనించండి.
ఇస్ జహాజ్ కే చాలక్ దల్ ద్వారా సటీక్ సంచాలన్ కి ఆవశ్యకత హోతీ హై. 40 नॉट या 70 किलोमीटर प्रति घंटे तक की गति और हल्के आयुध दागने की क्षमता इन्हें श्रेष्ठ बनाती है.
The ISVs leading the formation are Tango 40, commanded by Lieutenant Commander Ravi Kumar Singh, and Tango 38, commanded by Lieutenant Commander Jaydeep Singh Aluwalia.
ISV formation ka netritv Tango 40 aur Tango 38 ke yuva command adhikari Lieutenant Commander Ravi Kumar Singh aur Lieutenant Commander Jaydeep Singh Aluwalia dwara kiya ja raha hai.
ఈ ఏర్పాటులో ఉన్న ఐఎస్వీలు T-40కి లెఫ్టినెంట్ కమాండర్ రవికుమార్ సింగ్, T-38కి లెఫ్టినెంట్ కమాండర్ జైదీప్ సింగ్ ఆలువాలియా నాయకత్వం వహిస్తున్నారు.
The columns of the FICs are led by two ISVs on the front. Observe sharply as the FICs break out from the rear with the ISVs maneuvering in position.
अब हम आप सभी से अनुरोध करते हैं कि आप आसमान की ओर देखें, जहां आप मार्कोस स्काई डाइविंग टीम के तेज तर्रार सदस्यों को भारतीय तिरंगा और भारतीय नौसेना के ध्वज का गर्व से फहराते देखेंगे.
Ladies and gentlemen, look up to the skies and you will see the daring Marcos of INS Karn proudly displaying the Indian tricolor and the Indian naval ensign.
అందరూ ఆకాశం వైపు చూడండి. అక్కడ మీరు స్కైడైవింగ్ టీంలోని చురుకైన సభ్యులను చూడగలరు. భారతీయ త్రివర్ణ పతకాన్ని మరియు భారత నావికాదళ పతకాన్ని సగర్వంగా ప్రదర్శిస్తున్నారు.
Look carefully, ladies and gentlemen. The diver has landed with great precision right on the designated spot. Let us have a loud round of applause for the naval skydivers for the outstanding demonstration of courage and skill.
आपने देखा कि कैसे टीम के सदस्य बड़े कौशल के साथ निर्धारित स्थान पर उतरे हैं. देवियों और सज्जनों, साहस और कौशल के इस उत्कृष्ट प्रदर्शन के लिए नौसेना के इस मार्कोस स्काईडाइविंग टीम का जोरदार तालियों से स्वागत करें.
In actual combat, you can imagine how silently these warriors could land behind the enemy lines to take them by surprise.
The daredevil Marcos in today's display are from INS Kern, commanded by Captain Chetan Upadhyay.
इस प्रदर्शन को INS Kern के 6 मरीन कमांडो के दल द्वारा संचालित किया गया है, जिन्होंने 8000 फीट की ऊंचाई पर उड़ रहे LH हेलीकॉप्टर से गोता लगाया है. स्वदेशी निर्मित LH Mark 3 हेलीकॉप्टर को कमांडर SS दास उड़ा रहे हैं.
మీరు జాగ్రత్తగా గమనిస్తే స్కైడైవర్లు తమ పారాషూట్ యొక్క కదలికను నియంత్రిస్తున్నట్టు చూడొచ్చు.
Ladies and gentlemen, now Anoop, Chief Petty Officer, Clearance Diver, will present the Navy History Book to the Honorable President.
देवियों सज्जनों, बहादुर स्काईडाइवर अनूप सिंह चीफ पेटी ऑफिसर माननीय राष्ट्रपति को नेवी हिस्ट्री बुक भेंट कर रहे हैं.
The Indian Navy has been recording its history since 1945. Six books have been written in this series, keeping periodic history for gaining a sense of the growth of the Indian Navy through its actions and narratives. The current book, A Decade of Transformation, Signaling Power and Partnership, is authored by Captain M. Dorai Babu, Nausena Medal, and Commander Amrit Godbole. May I now request the Chief of Naval Staff to present a memento to the Honorable President of India.
देवियों और सज्जनों, अपनी बाईं ओर देखें. अब दो FIC और एक ISB आपके सामने 25 नॉट की गति से सेल पास्ट का प्रदर्शन कर रही हैं. ये नौकाएं अत्याधुनिक मशीनों और उपकरणों से लैस हैं और तटीय एवं अपतटीय प्रतिष्ठानों की रक्षा के लिए सबसे उन्नत नौकाओं में से एक हैं.
Firing flares, these vessels are also fitted with night vision devices, communication equipment, automatic identification system and a radar. The vessels carry a crew of 4 to 6 and can carry a variety of armament from heavy machine guns to grenade launchers. They are intended for intercepting suspicious boats for inspection and verification. Ladies and gentlemen, you can now see storming across the beach in a while BMPs of the Indian Army. BMPs are the combat vehicle of the infantry used for amphibious operations and are manned by troops of the Indian Army.
देवियों सज्जनों, यह तूफान सी दौड़ती लड़ाकू वाहन एम्फीबियस ऑपरेशन की शान BMP हैं, जो भारतीय नौसेना के साथ एक सामरिक युद्ध का अभ्यास का प्रदर्शन कर रही हैं. देवियों सज्जनों, अब आप सामरिक युद्ध अभ्यास करने के लिए डिव कॉलम में भारतीय नौसेना के युद्ध पोतों को देखेंगे. आपके सामने बाईं ओर से मिसाइल कॉर्वेट भारतीय नौसेना पोत खंजर है, जिसका नेतृत्व कमांडर एनवीएस फनी कुमार कर रहे हैं। इसके बाद पनडुब्बी रोधी कॉर्वेट जहाज कदमत है, जिसके कमान अधिकारी हैं कमांडर अनुराग राघव। और अंत में भारतीय नौसेना पोत किर्च की कमान कमांडर जीबी यदुवंशी नौसेना मेडल के ने संभाली है।
Ladies and gentlemen, right ahead of you, you will now witness the Indian naval warships in two columns undertaking tactical maneuvers. The two columns of the warships will now swap positions. You can see ahead of you from the left the missile corvette INS Khanjar, commanded by Commander NVS Fani Kumar, ASW corvette INS Kadmat, commanded by Commander Anurag Raghav, followed by the missile corvette INS Kirch, commanded by Commander GB Yadavanshi, Nausena Medal.
మీరు ఇప్పుడు భారత నౌకాదళ యుద్ధ నౌకలను ఒక వరుసలో చూస్తున్నారు. వ్యూహాత్మక విన్యాసాలను చేపట్టడానికి సమీపిస్తున్నాయి. యుద్ధ నౌకలు ఇప్పుడు తమ యుక్తిని అమలు చేస్తాయి. సముద్రం నుండి ఒడ్డువైపు నౌకలు మారుతూ ఉంటాయి. ముందుగా మీ ఎడమవైపున కమాండర్ ఎన్వీఎస్ ఫణికుమార్ నేతృత్వంలో మిసైల్ కార్వెట్ ఐఎన్ఎస్ ఖంజర్ను, కమాండర్ అనురాగ్ రాఘవ్ నేతృత్వంలోని ఏఎస్డబ్ల్యూ కార్వెట్ ఐఎన్ఎస్ కద్మత్ మరియు కమాండర్ జీబీ యదువంశి నౌసేనా మెడల్ నేతృత్వంలో మిసైల్ కార్వెట్ ఐఎన్ఎస్ కిర్చ్లను చూడవచ్చు.
Warships very often maneuvered in close proximity to each other for operational and training purposes. These maneuvers demand great precision and skill, especially when operating close to land. Except while entering harbor, sailing towards land is an avoidable activity, as the decreasing depth of water makes it difficult for the ships to navigate safely. However, when supporting activity ashore, such as an amphibious landing or army operations deep inside territory, ships may have to operate close to land.
परिचालन और प्रशिक्षण उद्देश्यों के लिए युद्धपोत अक्सर एक दूसरे के करीब युद्ध अभ्यास करते हैं। विशेष रूप से यह युद्ध अभ्यास तट के समीप संचालन करते समय बहुत सटीकता और कुशलता की मांग करते हैं। बंदरगाह में प्रवेश करने के अलावा भूमि की ओर नौकायन एक अपरिहार्य गतिविधि है, क्योंकि पानी की घटती गहराई से जहाजों को सुरक्षित रूप में नेविगेट करना मुश्किल हो जाता है। इसके लिए नेविगेशन में सटीकता, सटीक फिक्सिंग और बहुत सटीक गणना की आवश्यकता होती है।
Ladies and gentlemen, you can now see the warships firing flares as they tactfully move in a formation. The maneuver being displayed requires exactness in navigation, frequent and precise position fixing, and calculating very accurately the point to turn away. Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for the mighty ships of the Eastern Fleet.
अब आपके सामने दूसरा कॉलम देख रहे हैं, जिनमें बाईं ओर से कैप्टन शिराज आजाद की कमान में स्वदेश निर्मित शक्तिशाली विध्वंसक पुत डली है, और मध्य में स्वदेश निर्मित स्टेल्थ फ्रिगेट भारतीय नौसेना पुत सहयाद्री है, जिसके कमान अधिकारी हैं कैप्टन मंजीत एम थॉमस, और अंत में स्वदेश निर्मित विध्वंसक पुत कोच्चि की कमान कैप्टन हिमाद्री बोस के हाथों में है।
As the ships to seaward approach the shore, you can now see three mighty warships approaching from your left. The indigenously built destroyer INS Delhi, commanded by Captain Shiraz Azad, followed by the indigenously built frigate INS Sayadri, commanded by Captain Manjit M. Thomas in the center, and the indigenously built destroyer INS Kochi, commanded by Captain Himadri Bose. Look right ahead, ladies and gentlemen, let us have a loud round of applause for Commander Karthik Malhotra and Wing Commander Tuhin Mukherjee, the pilots of the two Hawk aircraft.
हवा में करतब कर रहे भारतीय नौसेना के लड़ाकू विमान हॉक हैं, जो ध्वनि से तेज उड़ने की क्षमता रखते हैं। इन दो विमानों का संचालन कमांडर कार्तिक मल्होत्रा और विंग कमांडर तुहिन मुखर्जी कर रहे हैं।
big round of applause for these hawks undertaking low-level tactical maneuver. Ladies and gentlemen, coming up from the left to enthrall you are the indigenous helicopters Chetak and an ALH helicopter to demonstrate the search and rescue demo.
Devi aur Sajjano, ab aap Swadesh Nirmit Chetak aur ALH Mark 3 helicopter ko khoj aur bachav ka pradarshan karte dekhenge.
The indigenously built Chetak helicopter is extensively used for logistic support, medivac and SAR missions over both land and sea, earning themselves the name of angels. Recently inducted, these indigenously built machines come with the state-of-the-art equipment, all-weather and all-machine capable.
जैसा कि आप देख रहे हैं चेतक से एक गोताखोर विंच का उपयोग करके पानी में उतर रहा है जो संकट में फंसे व्यक्ति को बचाएगा एएलएच हेलीकॉप्टर से एक खोज व बचाव टोकरी को नीचे उतारा जाएगा जिसका उपयोग रेस्क्यू के लिए किया जाता है
As you can see a free diver is being lowered from Chetak making his way to recover the casualty using a winch simultaneously you can also see a search and rescue basket which was lowered from the ALH along with the diver to rescue the casualty by placing him into the basket.
इस ऑपरेशन में ALH Mark 3 विमान का संचालन कमांडर कैलाश नायर कर रहे हैं और कमांडर बंसीधर चेतक हेलीकॉप्टर को उड़ा रहे हैं जिनका सहयोग सौरभ NA1 फ्लाइट डाइवर कर रहे हैं.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a loud round of applause for Lieutenant Commander Kailash Nair piloting the ALH and Commander Bansidhar piloting the Chetak and for the daring flight diver Saurabh NA1 who you saw was being winched.
इस ऑपरेशन के लिए बहुत अभ्यास और कौशल की आवश्यकता होती है. समुद्र सतह से उचित ऊंचाई को बरकरार रखना आवश्यक है अन्यथा रोटर द्वारा उत्पन्न रोटर वॉश हेलीकॉप्टर के लिए खतरनाक हो सकते हैं. देवी और सज्जनों आपके समक्ष भारतीय नौसेना के चार शक्तिशाली युद्धपोत हैं वह एक कॉलम में व्यवस्थित हैं. बाईं ओर से स्वदेश निर्मित शक्तिशाली विध्वंसक पोत दिल्ली है. इसके पीछे स्वदेश निर्मित स्टेल्थ फ्रिगेट भारतीय नौसेना पोत सह्याद्री है. इसके बाद पश्चिमी बेड़े का स्वदेश निर्मित विध्वंसक पोत कोची है और अंत में लैंडिंग प्लेटफॉर्म डॉक भारतीय नौसेना पोत जलाश्व जिसकी कमान कैप्टन ऋषि राज कोहली के हाथों में है. अब आप एक साथ चार जहाजों पर क्रमशः चेतक ALH Mark 3 सीकिंग चार्ली और सिकोस्की US-3H हेलीकॉप्टर लैंडिंग करते देखेंगे.
लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन राइट इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू आर द फोर माइटी वॉरशिप्स ऑफ द इंडियन नेवी. दे आर इन अ कॉलम फॉर्मेशन दैट इज वन बिहाइंड द अदर. In the lead to the left is the indigenous destroyer INS Delhi with the Chetak helicopter piloted by Lieutenant Commander Hari landing on its deck, followed by the indigenous frigate INS Sahyadri with the advanced light helicopter piloted by Commander Subrat Tripathi. Thereafter, from the western fleet is the indigenously built INS Kochi with a Sea King Charlie piloted by Commander Shailendra Singh, Nausena Medal. And in the end, the INS Jalashwa commanded by Captain Rishiraj Kohli, the landing platform dock with a UH-3H helicopter piloted by Commander Chandan Tantri on finals. You shall now witness the landing of the halos on four ships.
భారత నావిక నావికాదళానికి చెందిన నాలుగు శక్తివంతమైన యుద్ధ నౌకలు మీ ముందు ఉన్నాయి. అవి నిలువ వరుసలో ఉన్నాయి అనగా ఒక దాని వెనుక ఒకటి. శక్తివంతమైన స్వదేశీ యుద్ధనౌకైన డిస్ట్రాయర్ ఐఎన్ఎస్ ఢిల్లీ పైన చేతక్, వెనక స్వదేశీ యుద్ధనౌకైన ఐఎన్ఎస్ సహ్యాద్రి పైన ఏలెచ్, ఆ తర్వాత శక్తివంతమైన స్వదేశీ యుద్ధనౌకైన డిస్ట్రాయర్ ఐఎన్ఎస్ కొచ్చి పైన సీకింగ్, చివరిగా కెప్టెన్ రిషిరాజ్ కోహ్లీ నేతృత్వంలోని ల్యాండింగ్ ప్లాట్ఫామ్ డాక్ ఐఎన్ఎస్ జలశివ పైన యుఎస్టీహెచ్ ఏకకాలంలో ల్యాండింగ్ చేయడం మీరు చూడగలరు.
స్వాగత్ కరే శక్తిశాలి ఆర్ అద్భుత్ యుద్ధ పోతుం కా. INS Kochi is the second ship of the Kolkata class stealth guided missile destroyers built under the code name Project 15 Alpha for the Indian Navy. She was constructed by the Mazagon Dock Limited MDL in Mumbai.
Ladies and gentlemen, look right ahead. You will witness the aircraft carrier bomb fighter of the Indian Navy, the MiG-29K, the Black Panthers as they call themselves, approaching the dais to undertake low-level tactical maneuvers. The pilot of the approaching fighter is Panther leader Captain S.S. Samyal. He will roll the aircraft at 90 degrees angle of bank and pull 6 times against the force of gravity as he performs a hard turn to display the superior turn capability of the mighty MiG-29 aircraft. The MiG-29K squadron has chosen one of the rarest and fiercest predators to be its mascot, and they proudly call themselves the Black Panthers. Befitting the lethality of the aircraft and indomitable spirit of the squadron, their war cry, Asambhav Bhi Sambhav. The pilot will now approach the dials, displaying the slow speed characteristics of a 4++ generation aircraft. Ladies and gentlemen, hold your breath as we will light up the skies by dispensing multiple flares. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together as he will light up the skies once again and pull the fighter up towards the sky as he performs the famous vertical Charlie maneuver. Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for the Panther leader. The MiG-29K is a true swing roll aircraft which carries enough punch to undertake air dominance and power projection missions simultaneously, bestowing the commander at sea great flexibility.
देवियों और सज्जनों, तालियों की गड़गड़ाहट से स्वागत करें, क्योंकि अब आपके सामने क्षितिज पर पूर्वी बेड़े के जहाजों को एंटी सबमरीन रॉकेट फायरिंग करते देखेंगे. फॉर्मेशन का नेतृत्व कैप्टन कार्तिक मूर्ति की कमान में स्वदेशी निर्मित स्टेल्थ फ्रिगेट भारतीय नौसेना पुत सतपुरा द्वारा किया जा रहा है. इसके बाद कमांडर सी के कोठारी के नेतृत्व में स्वदेशी निर्मित पंडुप विरोधी कॉर्वेट जहाज कवरती और कमांडर अर्जित पांडे के नेतृत्व में भारतीय नौसेना पुत किल्तान है। पिछले हिस्से में कैप्टन मनु की कमान में शक्तिशाली विध्वंसक पुत रणविजय और कैप्टन मिलिंद मुकाशी शौर्य चक्र की कमान में भारतीय नौसेना पुत राणा है।
Ladies and gentlemen, firing flares, the ships have just indicated their readiness to commence rocket firing. You will witness simultaneous firing of rockets by all ships of the formation. Ladies and gentlemen, you just witnessed the simultaneous firing of rockets by the ships. These rockets are intended for protection of ships against submarines. Though not clearly visible, I'm sure you would have been able to hear the sound. Ladies and gentlemen, the ships have now indicated the completion of rocket firing. A big round of applause for the ships that just carried out anti-submarine rocket firing, lethal as they go.
After witnessing the swift action at sea, let me redirect your attention to the skies. After witnessing the swift action at sea, let me redirect your attention to the blue skies coming from the left as we showcase the range of aircraft that are operated by the Eastern Naval Command. Look to the skies on your left where you will see the formation of helicopters approaching. Clap and wave as the helicopters pass over you. In the lead, you can see the Chetak helicopter in arrow formation, led by Commander Ashish Raina, who is displaying the national flag, followed by Lieutenant Commander Ishan Kuchar, displaying the naval ensign. These indigenously built helicopters are extensively used for logistic support, medical evacuation, and SAR missions over both land and sea. Give it away for the indigenously built ALH Mark III helicopters. The Kestrel formation, piloted by Commander S.S. Dash, Lieutenant Commander Kailash Nair, and Commander Subrat Tripathi. Recently inducted, these machines come with a state-of-the-art equipment and a full glass cockpit display. All weather, all mission capable, the ALH. Now appearing right in front of you is the SARS formation comprising of the medium-lift Sikorsky, UH-3H and the Sea King Bravo. The formation is led by Commander Vijay V. Senthil and the Sea King Bravo is piloted by Commander Kaustubh Banerjee. Being the only special operations squadron of the Eastern Seaboard, better known as the SARS, has pioneered the use of advanced SAR gears in the Indian Navy, operating the UH-3H helicopters. These versatile machines are utilized for search and rescue, casualty evacuation, underslung operations, the sty ops, and security of offshore installations.
Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for the rotor wings of the Indian Naval Aviation.
Keeping always a sharp look out for foes and ruling over the sky, behold the arrival of the Indian Navy's Dornier aircraft in the four aircraft kite formation led by kite leader Commander Amit Kumar, commanding officer of the Indian Naval Air Squadron 311. The versatile Dornier 228 aircraft, equipped with the state-of-the-art sensors and employed for maritime reconnaissance, electronic warfare, para-jumps, medical evacuation and communication duties, is a true multi-role aircraft of the Indian Navy. The game changes, as they call themselves, roaring the sky with glory. Here comes the P-8I of the Indian Navy, piloted by Lieutenant Commander Guru Prasad, Lieutenant Commander Ritesh Gore, with Lieutenant Commander Paul S. George as the mission controller. Based on Boeing 737-800 new generation airframe, P-8I is a long-range maritime reconnaissance aircraft equipped with both foreign and indigenous sensors for maritime reconnaissance, anti-submarine operations and electronic intelligence missions. Look up and wave.
Lighting the skies, the P-8I. Let's have a loud round of applause for the P-8I of Indian Navy.
As you look to your left, be ready to gasp. You will witness a daring display of precision with the formation of Hawk aircraft making its way to the dais. Hawk advanced jet trainer, stepping stone for every fighter pilot of Indian Navy, a single engine trainer aircraft, transforming pilots to professional fighter pilots. The Phantom formation is led by Captain Sharad Daya, the Phantom leader.
Air superiority does have a face to it. The 4++ generation aircraft flying in a formation are the aircraft carrier launched MiG-29Ks. A testament to the sheer power and prowess of these machines, let us have a loud round of applause for the Black Panthers as they will soon approach. Approached from your left are the Panthers in arrowhead formation, stand by to get swayed. Ladies and gentlemen, look to your left again, closing it at over 900 km per hour is another MiG-29K piloted by Commander Saurav Kotiyal, which will carry out a vertical Charlie, a testament to sheer power and speed of this deck-based fighter aircraft of the Indian Navy. From a low height, this aircraft will be pulling up by 90 degrees and climb like a rocket. Ladies and gentlemen, hold your breath. Approaching the dais now is the mighty MiG of the Indian Navy. Ladies and gentlemen, as a befitting end to the spectacular flypast, you can now look right ahead as the MiG-29K aircraft will approach the dais one by one at high speed and will display sheer power and high thrust capability by pulling the aircraft to mirror vertically up. Let us have a loud round of applause for these warriors.
देवियों और सज्जनों, अपूर्वी नौसेना कमान बैंड एक सदियों पुरानी प्रथा बीटिंग रिट्रीट प्रस्तुत करने जा रही है। यह समारोह युद्ध विराम के पश्चात होता है। देवियों और सज्जनों, आपके समक्ष प्रस्तुत पूर्वी नौसेना कमान बैंड। आज बैंड का नेतृत्व शरद कुमार सिंह बाबू, चीफ पेटी ऑफिसर म्यूजिशियन कर रहे हैं।
Ladies and gentlemen, we will now witness the age-old tradition of beating retreat through the collective melody of our Navy band. Beating retreat is a centuries-old military tradition dating from the days when troops disengaged from the battle at sunset. As soon as the buglers sounded retreat, the troops ceased fighting, sheathed their arms, and withdrew from the battlefield. Ladies and gentlemen, bringing this delight to you, the Eastern Naval Command Band. Today the band is being led by Sharad Kumar Singh Babu, Chief Petty Officer, Musician.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will now have the sunset ceremony. You are now kindly requested to remain standing while the flags are being lowered. Officers in uniform are requested to salute.
Andaru suryastama vedukaku nilabadavalsindiga kortunnamu.
Ladies and gentlemen, sunset. Seated. You shall see a spectacular show right ahead of you, where the ships shall illuminate their silhouette and fire flares with exact military precision. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a hand. Put your hands together and give a rousing applause for these mighty ships and the brave men who man them. The sea is a hard taskmaster, and extraordinary is every day. The Indian Navy responds swiftly, charting new horizons, finding new solutions, and being extraordinary every ordinary day. For Indian Navy, a combat-ready, credible, cohesive, and future-proof force, it is always business unusual. A blue-water Navy, the Indian Navy is tasked with ensuring national security, strengthening international relations, building bridges of friendship, promoting maritime security, and delivering humanitarian aid and disaster relief. Once again, a loud round of applause for these mighty ships of the Eastern Fleet. Ladies and gentlemen, request a big round of applause for the Eastern Naval Command Band. May I now draw your attention right ahead once again. You will now witness firing of illumination bombs from the ships. The ships will be undertaking close-range anti-aircraft firing. This firing is the last line of defense for ships at sea. The ships in firing column are the mighty warships of the Eastern Fleet. Ships at sea not only fire missiles and rockets at the enemy, but also must repulse attacks from enemy aircraft and missiles. What you're witnessing now is a demonstration of anti-air warfare. The ships are undertaking firing of a series of illumination bombs. The Eastern Fleet of the Indian Navy is known as the Sunrise Fleet and the Western Fleet, the Sword Arm. The Eastern Fleet is headquartered at Visakhapatnam, Andhra Pradesh on the east coast of India. It is a part of the Eastern Naval Command and is responsible for the naval forces in the Bay of Bengal and parts of the Indian Ocean, and is an instrumental defense to the eastern seaboard as a whole. All ships that you see in front of you, ladies and gentlemen, are the warriors of the Eastern Fleet. Today also marks a very special day for the Indian Navy as it sheds its colonial legacy and embarks on a new journey with the unveiling of the new president's standard and color. Indian Navy crest and CNS standard will also be unveiled. The new president's standard was also displayed by the Guard of Honor today afternoon. Ladies and gentlemen, the new president's standard and color is now being flashed on the screen. The new Navy crest is now being flashed on the screen. The new CNS standard is being flashed on the screen.
Good evening, everybody. After this amazing display, I don't have any words, but just to say that it's such a proud feeling being here. And today being, no, really, I mean, I'm overwhelmed. The presence of Honorable President and all the dignitaries over here, we can see that despite it being Navy Day, there is amazing presence of all the other forces too. So this song that I'm going to sing for you is a song which we had composed, me and my two brothers, Ehsan and Loy. It's written by Javed Akhtar Saab. It's a song about achieving your goals, which we could see over here. I dedicated to all the armed forces over here. This is the song. And hum bas yahi prarthana karenge ke hamara jo bhi laksh hai, each one of us, wo laksh pura ho.
भारत की माननीय राष्ट्रपति और भारतीय सशस्त्र बलों की सर्वोच्च सेनापति से सभा को संबोधित करने का अनुरोध करते हैं।
May I now request the Honorable President of India and the Supreme Commander of the Indian Armed Forces to address the gathering.
Governor of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Biswamishwar Harichandanji, Union Minister of Tourism, Culture and Development of Northeast Region, Sri G. Kishan Reddy Ji, Rakhya Rajya Mantri Sri Ajay Bhatt Ji, Chief of the Naval Staff, Admiral R. Hari Kumar Ji, Speaker of Andhra Pradesh, Sri T. Sitharaman Ji, Minister of Industries, Infrastructure, Investment and Commerce, and IT, Sri G. Amarnath Ji, Minister of Health, Family Welfare and Medical Education, Srimati B. Rajini Ji, Flag Officer, Commanding of Chief of Eastern Naval Command, Vice Admiral Biswajit Dasgupta Ji, Spouse of the Chief of the Naval Staff, Srimati Kalahari Kumar Ji, Flag Officers, Officers and Men of the Armed Forces, Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I congratulate you all on this Navy Day. Today, I am pleased to attend the Navy Day celebration in Visakhapatnam, the jewel of the East Coast. Visakhapatnam has a rich history, and being the headquarters of Eastern Naval Command and an industrial and port city, it has emerged as an important hub, paving way for India's secure future. We celebrate this day to commemorate the Indian Navy's valiant actions in the 1971 war, contributing to India's historic victory. It is a day to remember and honor our martyrs who etched a permanent place for themselves in history and continue to inspire every generation. Today, we acknowledge the vision, foresight, and effort of the naval veterans. This day also reminds us to rededicate ourselves to taking India forward, transiting through Amrit Kal towards a great future. In many ways, this future is inextricably linked to the oceans, just as our past was strongly influenced by these waters. We are an inherently maritime nation with the sea on three sides and high mountains on the fourth. It is but natural that the oceans will play a vital role in India's growth and prosperity. Indian Navy has a huge responsibility of ensuring an umbrella of security for India's national maritime interest. Ladies and gentlemen, Indian Navy remains firm in its perseverance, resolute in commitment, futuristic in capability development, and outcome-oriented in action. It is also evident from the theme of this Navy Day, combat ready, credible, cohesive, and future-proof force. Indian Navy is driven by Atmanirbhar, has a sustained reach and presence across the oceans, and is propelled by innovation. As your Supreme Commander, I am confident that the Indian Navy will continue to grow from strength to strength, allied with the vision of a new and developed India. The gallant men and women of the Indian Navy are serving a greater cause with utmost dedication, and I am extremely proud of each one of you. Ladies and gentlemen, today I am happy to inaugurate and lay foundation stone of various projects of Ministry of Road Transport and Highways, Ministry of Defense and Ministry of Tribal Affairs. National Open Air Range established by Defense Electronics and Research Laboratory in Kurnool District is a state-of-the-art facility. I am happy to learn that This facility will serve the purpose of India's defense preparedness and will be an asset to the nation. I congratulate Sri Rajnath Singh Ji for his able leadership and guidance to DRDO for setting up this facility. The road transport projects will help in easing traffic congestion, improving road safety and reducing travel time, thereby facilitating faster and smooth movement of goods and people in the state. I congratulate Sri Nitin Gadkari Ji and Ministry of Road Transport and Highways for inauguration of Raicholi to Angula section of NH340, 4-lane ROB of NH205 and 6-lane grade separated structures in Kurnool. I am happy to lay the foundation stone and convey my best wishes for the project of widening of road from Mudiguba to Puttaparthi on NH342. Ekalabhya Model Residential School are playing major role in providing quality education to tribal youth. I am sure that four schools inaugurated today at Butaya Gudian in West Godavari and Chinturu and Raja Bombi in East Godavari and at Guma Lakmipuram in Vijayanagaram will go a long way in educating our tribal children and will help in their all-round development through academics and extracurricular activities. I congratulate Sri Arjun Munda Ji and Ministry of Tribal Affairs for this initiative. We must ensure that every child in India gets education, no matter where or in what condition he or she resides. Education has to be accessible to each and everyone. I am certain that these projects will contribute immensely towards India's holistic and inclusive development. We have to bridge the gaps so that all Indians can march forward with pride and step into the new and developed India. I again convey my greetings and best wishes to you all and your families on this Navy Day. May the Indian Navy continue to remain victorious in its service to India and her people. Before I conclude, main sabhi deshvasiyon ko dhanyabad dena chahti hu. Bharat ko isiliye mahan kaha jata hai. Bharat aise desh hai. Bharat jon jon mein Bharat ki logon mein aise urja hai. Geet, sangeet, sanskriti, khel, kood, jawan, har ek log देश को आगे बढ़ाने के लिए कदम बढ़ा रहे हैं. मुझे लगता है देश जो 100 वर्ष या आज़ादी का 100 साल पूरा करेगी, ये देश जरूर पूरा विश्व का गुरु बनेगा और उसका पूर्व गौरव जरूर से वापस लाएगा. इसी के साथ मैं पुनः आप सबको बहुत बहुत बधाई देती हूँ. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat, Jai Jawan.
आप सभी से अनुरोध है कि राष्ट्रगान के लिए अपने स्थान पर खड़े हो जाएं.
ఇప్పుడు మీ అందర్ని జాతీయ గీతం కోసం నిలబడవలసిందిగా కోరుతున్నాము.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, all guests are requested to be seated till departure of the chief guest.
ముఖ్య అతిథి బయలుదేరే వరకు అతిథులందరూ కూర్చోవాలని కోరుతున్నాము.
సభీ అతిథియోసే అనురోధ హై కి ముఖ్య అతిథి కే జానే తక్ అప్నే స్థాన్ పర్ బనే రహే.